Today, we're talking about how to push the film look in post-production. Welcome to Film Riot. Before we jump into what we're talking about today, which is getting a film look in post, kind of, I'll explain in a second. Just want to again remind you that Black Friday is coming. It's the day after Thanksgiving, which I believe is the 23rd. We have all kinds of crazy, insane deals coming where we're basically giving our stuff away to some degree. And we have a bunch of really cool products with some of those coming out with some promos for you guys to check out very soon. I'm really excited about some of the new stuff that we have, so keep a lookout for that. Also, the 1 minute short film competition is still going on. If you have not joined, definitely do that. We have tons of awesome prizes. Check a link in the notes below to get involved with that. We have a website that has all the details and deals and a whole video that explains everything. But now to what we're talking about today, which is pushing that film look, which the film look is kind of a funny thing in and of itself, because you kind of got to jump down to what is the film look even, because when you shoot on film, that has a wide range of looks. I've seen films shot on film that looked digital. So the film look for me really is this psychological connection between what we deem as cinematic. So usually stretching back to those things that we saw that were younger, that had those big magical moments. So for me, it was things like Jurassic Park and Indiana Jones, these films that had that texture to them, that something extra to them that felt cinematic. So that is what we're trying to emulate, not how celluloid captures light, because you can really get an Alexa, Red, a DSLR to look like film if you know what you're doing. And that is what we're trying to emulate, that look and cinematic feel that gives the audience that emotion, that filmic emotion, not how celluloid literally reacts to light. Of course, all of this starts in production. If you have bad footage, you're never really going to fully be able to salvage it. You can tweak and work on it quite a bit and get it to a decent place, but to really capture that filmic feel, you have to get it in camera. And that's not just the lighting. It's where you place the camera, what lenses you're using, how you block the scene, what your actors are wearing, what location, and even how your coverage is placed. So when you're cutting in between things, those are going to inform that filmic feel as well. Because again, it's not just what it looks like, literally looks like, it's really what it feels like that we're trying to capture. But if you've done your job in production, in post-production, there's some things that you could do to put icing on the cake to really push it toward that filmic feel. Things like grain and aspect ratio are usually gonna help you to give your audience that filmic feel. So to get that, I'm in Premiere Pro right now, and I have a couple of shots here that we're gonna mess around with. A couple of Todd, one from a recent shoot we did for Bloodtober, and one of Josh and Emily, most of them from an old short film we did called Portal Combat. Now, the first thing I do when I'm color grading is add an adjustment layer, which you can do in your project panel by going to New Item and then down to Adjustment Layer. And I've already put one here on top of all of my footage. Of course, it's not on top of my aspect bars, which we'll throw on later because we don't wanna adjust those. We want those just staying black bars, but it's overall all of my footage. That way I can set a broad look for everything and then go in and correct the shots individually to balance them. But we're not going to be getting into corrections here between shots. We're talking about creative color grades. Corrections would be when you're balancing the shots to each other, balancing the exposure. We're not going to get into all of that. We have talked about that on episodes before, so I'll put a link for that in the notes below. And there's one plugin that I've always used to push toward that filmic feel, and it's ended up in every bit of footage that I've ever done, usually toward the end of the chain of things that I've done to get the look where I wanted, and that's a plugin called Film Convert. Now, I've used them for years, and recently we've partnered with them, so I wanted to give you guys a walkthrough of this plugin. So I'll drag this onto my adjustment layer, and right off the bat, it's giving us a look. And what's great about this is it's emulating different stocks of film. So first, right here, you have source camera, so you can put in what camera, make, and model that you used, so it can be more specific towards your footage. Then you have exposure and temperature, so these are the things that you can tweak a little bit, that correction before you get into the creative grade. And this does feel a little bit on the hot side, so I'll drop this down just a little bit. Then we go down to the film settings where all the goodies are, and we can convert to different film stock looks. So we could just scroll through here and we could see off the bat that they have all these different looks based off of the actual film stock itself. And a lot of these are good right off the bat, but I can scroll through here until I find the look that's most hitting the feel that I want for this piece. Then below that, we can set our size. So we can go all the way down to 8mm, then up to Super 8, 16mm, Super 16, 35mm Academy, 3 Perf, Super 35, and 35 Full Frame, which I'm usually on 35 Full Frame because I'm wanting more of a subtle look, but you can go down the chain to dirty it up however much you want. Then we can play with our softness, and then film color, curve, and grain. And this is where I'm usually playing the most to dial it in. Film color, as you can see, is gonna push the intensity of that look it's doing, balancing between your original and that. I'll dial it back to about 80. Then film curve, which is messing with that contrast that it's adding on there. Again, I'll dial that back just a bit. And then grain, we can push this all the way up to 200% to really push that grain in there, or pull it down to keep it nice and clean. I usually set this somewhere between 57 and 70 because I'm usually using it as something that you're feeling and not seeing. So after I've done all the work to the image, I'm just adding the grain at the end to be that thing that's really gluing everything together and making it all feel nice and unified. This helps a lot with visual effects as well. But with this one, it's not showing up a ton because it is a daytime shot, and I am wanting this to be a little on the dirty side. So I'm gonna crank this up until we can really see it. And I'm starting to see it pretty good around 128, 130. So I'll set it there. Now we can dial into our grade further by going into color correction. And you have all the wheels here and your saturation. So we could push that saturation just a bit. And then I'm gonna go down to values. I never really do the wheels here. I find it a lot easier to come into the values and do it one at a time this way. So we can come into shadows, crank the amount all the way up, which is an easy way to do this. If you're wanting to put some colors into the shadows, by cranking that all the way up, you can really see exactly what it's going to be doing. Then I can find the color that I'm liking. Let's say we like that one right there. And then we'll just push a little bit into the shadows. Now we'll shift over into our midtones and do the exact same thing. And then our highlights, again, doing the exact same thing. I'm usually not pushing color into my highlight, and if I do, it's just the slightest bit, just offset maybe what the mids are doing, but I'm happy with that, so I'm gonna leave that as is. And of course, with all those, you have the gain as well, so you can jump in and adjust that, but I'm gonna do that down here in levels. And right here, you have your histogram, and this is just the same as any other levels that you would use. You adjust, you see the histogram is adjusting to what you're doing here. I'll darken up my mids just a little bit, and then there we go. Then we have our render options, and the best part about this is you can turn all of your work into a LUT, so you can use this as a temp look for your project if you are using a colorist. Turn it into a LUT, send that LUT to your colorist or your VFX artist so they can see what the end result is going to be, so you're all working together on the same page. And now with all that, we have a before and our after. Now, I'm not always just grading only in Film Convert like this. I just showed it to you like this because I thought it would be good to run through the entire plugin. What I'm usually doing is throwing on an instance of Lumetri, getting a basic correction in the basic correction section like I did right here, just adjusting the exposure just a little bit because it does feel a little hot. Then I can come down in Creative and go into some LUTs that I have installed here, which this is a new LUT pack that we have coming onto the store for Black Friday. This is Cinematic LUTs Volume 3, which is based off of a bunch of movies that came out this year. So I can scroll through here until I'm finding something that's matching the look and feel that I'm wanting for this footage. And I think something in this range will probably be good. And just like we did in Filmstro, we can then come to intensity and cycle between the original and the look of the LUT until we get an intensity that's working for our footage. It looks a little too extreme on this footage at 100%, so I'll just dial that back to about 74 is looking good to me. And that's how you use LUTs in general or any kind of preset. It's just a starting point that you then adjust to your footage to get it to work as best as it possibly can. But now that I have that, I'll jump back into basic correction and then just adjust a few things to get it exactly where I want it. So now I can jump back down here and grab Film Convert again and toss it onto my footage as the final touch. So now once I've done that, really the only things that I'm touching in Film Convert would be film color, curve, and grain. So I'm gonna drop curve down a little bit because it's making a little more contrasty than I want it to be now. Then I'll mess around with the color in the same way and then decide how much grain I'm wanting to push into my image. Again, I can go crazy with it or I could dial it way back. We want this to feel dirty and gritty, so let's go to 150. And now we have our look. So now if we toggle the adjustment layer on and off, we could see how much that's doing for our footage. And then we could take it even further by putting the aspect ratio bars on. And once you've done that, of course, you're gonna wanna adjust your framing, which is one thing I really love about shooting full frame and then cropping in, is because it gives you that extra room to be able to move around to really nail the composition that you were hoping for. Like with this shot here, we can just adjust Todd until we have that look that we want. And now, since we have our overall look on this adjustment layer, as we go through these shots, we see that we do need to adjust them. So now we can put Lumetri on the shots themselves and correct it so it works well with the overall look that we already made. So I put this shot in here of Todd because this is a good example of something that wasn't got in camera and we're gonna try to salvage in post, but it's really sucking the life out of that filmic look and feel because Todd's up against this extremely bright background with no detail back there. So we're killing the depth, it's overexposed, and it has kind of a gross feel to it. Now, again, we can add Lumetri and adjust our values to get it to look as best as we possibly can. And with a shot like this, what I would usually do is drop the exposure and let everything else play a little bit dark so you're not overexposing the background and having it do that wrap it does around objects when it is so overexposed. So instead, I'll just let it all play a little bit dark to try to salvage it as best I can. And that's usable, but definitely not ideal and definitely breaking a little bit of that filmic look. But again, we can cycle through these and you can see we have totally different shots, all of which are matching nicely to each other just because we put an overall look above them all and then adjusted them independently to get our unified feel. Then jumping to the last shot I have in here, which is this clown shot we did for Bloodtober. We did shoot this very dark on purpose. We wanted it to stay dark and it did, but say we didn't mean to do that and we boosted the exposure. Well, that's gonna bring up a lot of noise in our image as you can see here. And this is another place where Film Convert comes in handy. So on a shot like this, the first thing I'll do is denoise my footage. So I'll throw on something like Neat Video's noise reducer. So if we before and after, you can see how much this is doing to get rid of that gross video noise, but it's also now giving us a clinical sort of glossy look, way more than what we want. But now we can go ahead and bring in Film Convert and reintroduce some grain to have that nice clean film texture without all that gross video noise. So still having that grit that we want to our image and that filmic look, but without the gross video vibe. But that's it. Links to everything that we use below. And again, I cannot stress it enough. Getting a filmic look and feel, a cinematic look and feel, all starts in production. If you don't get it there, you're pretty much never going to have it. You can sweeten things in post. You can correct and fix in post for sure. But if you don't have that solid look, if you don't have your intention up front, you're never going to be able to get it fully there in post-production. Don't think fix it in post, think sweeten in post. Domain.com is all your website needs, including .com and .net domain names and intuitive website builders to help you start creating your identity online. Domain.com is affordable, reliable, and has all the tools you need to build a website so you can start sharing your ideas with the world. And no domain extension is going to help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. And if you want to brand yourself online, Domain.com has over 300 domain name extensions to fit your needs from .club to .space. Of course, they're giving you 15% off their already affordable prices when you get domain names, web hosting, and email. Just use your coupon code FilmRiot at domain.com's checkout. When you think domain names, think domain.com.
Logo.
So that's it for today. Links to everything we talked about in the notes below. And of course, Black Friday coming on the 23rd. Big sales on everything. The LUT pack that I showed today and other LUT packs as well. We should have 3 to 4 new ones on top of other really cool things coming for you. But I'll see you next time when a little brown ball allows me to see someone's future.